The defending national champion set to go to camp later this week. We bring in Ryan Cantor from Shaking the Southland to break down the Clemson Tigers. Ryan, how you doing today?
Great. Thanks for having me.
Definitely. So it's good to be talking some college football, and especially let's start at the top at number one. And of course, the offense loses some multifaceted, dynamic program changing type players in Deshaun Watson, Mike Williams, and some others, Artavis Scott included. But at quarterback, at some other positions, you've got some reasons to be concerned, also some reasons to be rather excited, because Clemson has reached that status where the conveyor belt just keeps churning out 5- and 4-star athletes.
Yeah, so coinciding with Clemson's rise, as we won an Orange Bowl, won a Fiesta Bowl, got to a national championship, throughout that, one thing that's really helped in that process is getting better and better offensive line players. And that's something that's been a steady growing process, kind of lagged behind our ability to get great wide receivers, great quarterbacks, players like that. And now we're at the point where we've got a lot of very good offensive linemen who we were excited about, young guys breaking in, being better than their replacement, better than the players they replaced. And now we've got some veterans. He's a fantastic left tackle. He's now a junior. Broken started as a freshman in 2015, was a major reason Clemson went to a national championship. So he's in year three, maybe his final year if he goes to the NFL. Taylor Hearn at left guard's really developed. Tyrone Crowder, right guard's a very good run blocker and is supposed to be an improved pass blocker. And Sean Pollard came on last year as a true freshman, and he returns now with some experience and should be very good. At center, we have Justin Falsinelli and Gage Trevanka. That's still a position battle. And that's a little bit more of a concern there. So we had Jay Guillermo last year, who was excellent, and losing him, he's one of those guys that when you lose, you don't really fully get what you lose until you see what you had behind him. So a little bit of concern there.
Yeah, definitely. It could be argued that center is the second most important position on the offense. And as you mentioned, Guillermo, not just a talented player, but a guy that got everybody in place and was a stalwart along the offensive line. We've got Justin Falsinelli, Zach Giella as two players that have been noted as vying for that role at the center position.
You mentioned Zach Giella. One guy is Gage Trevanka of Greenwood, South Carolina. Small town, but puts out a ton of talent. He was actually recruited as a defensive lineman and is converted to center. We'll see if he's ready to start, but he may actually overtake the players who are recruited for that position if they're not ready.